And we are back with round two. So, let's see what the guy is planning to do this time. We fly through the buildings. Ah, fine horn work, I hear. Who is the purveyor of the horn? Let us see. And this must be, of course, the Floridian cavalry. It is! Fine Florida cavalrymen. Look at these guys, don't they look fantastic? There's Chewbacca. And look at this. Parking for horses. Good stuff indeed. So, let's move on and find out in the barn opposite what's going on, because we have these guys over here from the 7th Texan. There's Karl Marx. And in this area here, we have the 11th Texan. And I'm going to cough. Still suffering from some of the lurgy, but never mind. Anyway, these guys now moving up to the closer buildings. Nearer this thing. But it's going to be a bit of a problem because there are guys already in there breaking the windows. It is the 3rd US. And they are already repelling boarders against this attack. And cannonballs coming in from Kino Jr. taking down the quick one. Spooky and Murphster from Maine. In goes the pistol of Private Gentia. Look at that, he's looking for an opportunity. He wants to be careful he doesn't get shot. So let's see if we can find out. Is there, you can see the 3rd US, they've lost a couple of numbers. A few boys in here are in trouble. Oh, in comes Martau. And very, very brutal murder he was. And look at this, it looks like these guys are now under attack. The 1st Michigan Cavalry now going in for a charge and an attack. Oh, it looks like this could be unfortunate for these boys. As you can see, the 2nd MA unfortunately may not have got their bayonets ready in time for the attack of the Michigan Cavalry and the Floridian Cavalry getting involved as well. So they've been jumping in and getting involved. So this is all good stuff. Oh dear, the bleed has killed Yuji. Yuji is no more. So, look at that. As a murdering cavalry comes flying in and now disappears in clouds of dust. Is Retimer on the 8th floor. Wow, how did he not duck going in through that door? But never mind. At least he made it in. So, Charles Wicks, working together with the other members of the 68th New York. Kayuzu in there as well. And there's Corporal Samus. Now, who's this man by the flag? Staff Lieutenant Cocaine, working together with, of course, the fine mustachioed Numitor. Out comes the pistol. As we watch Numitor. Looking for a quarry. Or possibly not. So, Mitchell, wow. Kino Jr. doing a fantastic job with the kills there. 4 kills so far. So, looking pretty good as these guys here, annoying rain private. There we go, they're medicking. I do love the fact that they put medics and bandages in this game. I think it completely changes an aspect of the game. It means you have to have medics in because otherwise, you know, you get stabbed, you're going to bleed to death. It's a new level of realism, which I think is really, really good. So, here we go. Private Basti, you can see they've lost a few people here. But the 68th New York continue to fight. Now, let's see if we can look around and find out what's going on. Because, oh, look at this. The 1st Tennessee, Colonel Fernando moving up. And also the 2nd Connecticut, there's Marissi. Getting the boys together. And they will probably go for a nice brutal bayonet charge on these fellows. And it looks like they're actually using the train as a little bit of cover. As you can see these guys making their way through the center. There's Shaniqua. And look at that Cayuso with a nice kill with some canister shot as well. And these guys are now going to have to move. Well, perhaps not him. Poor Cayuso taken down. And now you can see Charles Wicks and others as the bleed takes Samus there. And now they're moving up. You can see them being very careful, trying to be careful. Charles Wicks charging after the enemy. Charles Wicks gets shot in the head by Mercury. Miss Spanky taking down Bastion, annoying Rain running around the corner to reload. As is the likes of Joanna Stern and others. Now, look at this. The casualties around this train. Absolutely brutal. And Zararon from the 68th New York looking for a target. Oh, he missed his opportunity. As that was Kajuba taking cover. And now it's a time for a little bit of melee fun on the train tracks. Oh, but he gets taken down. Zararon murdered at the last moment. And Staff Albert also finished off. So. Oh, he missed. He missed. It was close. Halugta. He's trying to get through. He's trying to look for a route round. Here's Recruit Harry. And there's Kajuba. And now you've got Staff Lieutenant Mercury with the Colt. Looking to do the damage with the Colt army. But these guys have safely taken cover. Oh, look at that. The 8th Florida Cavalry. Let's see if we can find them. As here is Kino. And working together with Charles Furtive, of course. A brave soul from the 21st Alabama. As down goes Chinchilla, as it looks like the 8th Florida Cavalry is claiming quite a few victims this evening. The question is, can we find the buggers? There's Numitor, Todas Angel, there we go. And there's Ippon taking down a member. There's Buzziomo. Look at this, we follow Ippon, who surprisingly is not charging today. Ouch! Zadie's taken down by Grozny with a slice across the back as he went past. Great shot with the saber there by Grozny. Very, very nasty, nasty slice there. And now you can see the horse forcing the others to the floor. Who is this last man standing? It's by Hector 11. And there's another guy there as well. It's Chewbacca. Watch out for Chewie. As you can see, Volunteer Thomas. He's got his rifle butt out. He's going to do a little bit of butt action. But constantly being... Oh, look at that! A lovely slice again by Grozny. Until finished off by Davy. So great swordplay and sword work there by here. By Grozny, unfortunately. It looks like Ippon might be the last one standing. How long will he remain standing is the question. Surrounded by cavalry, sliced to the bash to the floor. Nice block, another block by Ippon. Great play and defensive positioning by Ippon. Trying to use the cannon as a little bit of a defensive position. Oh, looks like a missed slice. Davy taken down by Ippon. Going in for more slice and dice here as we're watching Ippon. Currently go 2v1. Can Ippon go clutch is the question. As the battle continues to rage around her. As let's see, it might be the last one with the Michigan Cavalry. So it looks like it's by Hector 11 sliced across the back and Ippon finishes the deal. Fine play there. Fine saber work by Ippon. And supported ably by the Michigan Cavalry. Unfortunately, she seems to be on her own, so she'll probably charge somewhere soon. Barry Butterfield of the 3rd US, currently sitting in a building with a few holes in it. So let's see if we can find out what's going on. The 21st Alabama, there's Roosevelt, who seems to be having a seizure. Oh God, what's he doing? I think he's one of the loaders for the cannon. There's Charles. And Recruit Fox 400. So, let's have a look at the numbers. 23 and 21, it's all still to play for. And we're looking at the 7th Texan. Oh, correction, we're not looking at Monkey Boy anymore. He just caught a bullet from Darth Killer 454 of the United States Sharpshooters. Which I'm guessing will be these fine fellows over here. Of course it is. Look at that. You recognise those green uniforms anywhere? Don't they look wonderful? There's a recruit there. And there's Aragain. And the other members, look at these taking cover at the back here. Moped Trelol. And Colonel Brutus with the horn. Colonel Brutus with his horn. Plus I can get the officer horn. Look at that, assembling the boys. As is historically correct. But the question is Brutus now going to take some fire? Or will he be supported by these guys? Looks like the 3rd US, there's Gustav, supporting United States sharpshooters. As down goes Joanna Stern from Connecticut, taken down by Mexos. So these guys doing a good job. And in here, AKC VM King. Oh no, we've lost Brutus. Oh dear. Poor Brutus is no more. Where is he? I'm guessing that's him. But we've lost the commanding officer of the United States Sharpshooters. No doubt he will be avenged. And down goes Brigadier General Numitor, Private Mark from the 47th Virginia. That's two officers he's killed in a matter of minutes. You gotta watch out. Oh, Ippen's loading stuff. Look out, everyone. Ippen's got a cannon. Always dangerous. So, let's see if we can find out what's going on. Here is Cocaine with a pistol. There is the Michigan Regiment looking for potential. Here, the 16th Alabama. And here, also, annoying rain from the 7th Texas. These guys sticking together as Hanky-Panky McSpanky gets taken down. Fine name, indeed. Obviously, of the Connecticut McSpankies. And here is recruit John Smith from the 3rd US getting into a melee battle with PFC Lions from the 16th Alabama. And he takes down Butterfield, only to then die and get unceremoniously kicked in the testicles by his enemy. So, let's have a look. 17 and 11. And here we go. All charge. No firing. And it's time for the United States Sharpshooters. This might be a problem. He doesn't have a bayonet fixed. A lot of these guys may not have bayonets fixed. Some of them do. And they're firing off their guns to make sure they can't use them. And look at this, the colours of the Union Army being carried with pride. As Mark takes down John Smith and Joseph Joplin, Gustav Black as well. And here's Mark, who's been doing a fantastic job. Look at that, 4-1, nice ratio. As look at him, he's getting involved with a little bit of slice and dice. Is Mark getting in trouble? He is! Sliced across the back. Very nasty stuff as Colonel Anderson taken down by Cocaine. Yeah, it's a killer. Cocaine's a killer, that's for damn sure. So let's see if we can find out where the 7 remaining members of the Confederacy remain. Leading the way, it's Captain Schnurz from the United States Sharpshooters. There she is, the charger herself.
Charge!
Told you.
Kill those Yankee scum.
Here she goes.
Charge!
And now she goes up against Kino. Engineer, look at this. Oh, gets one slice, gets blocked again, gets hit. And a kill by Ippen. As another kill on one of the United States sharpshooters there. Norawetta. Oh, slice and dice and squishy noises. Another kill by Ippen. And then Dandy getting lion draw. So where is Ippen? What is she up to? Round the back. Here he is. It's Kino Jr. running for it. Turns and slices and kills Ippen. Turns and slices Ippen across the face. That's hardly a way to greet a lady. It's Kino Jr. But it's Kino Jr. is also a fellow lady. Until she is unceremoniously murdered. and we move on to a map change. And we return after a map change to the fine village or town, I suppose you could call. Now, I'm sure you're wondering, what is this fine town called? It is the town of Parrotsville, home of Parrots. Of course, one of the developers of the North and South mods, and we thank him for his hard work, along with all the other developers. Now, let's find out what's going on at Parrotsville. As here is Mercury, checking out with his binocs to find out what's going on. And we move up here to see the troops moving forward. And Lance Corporal Carrick from the 65Y, and the 7th Texan. Let's see. Oh, goodness me, there's flying horses. The 8th Florida Cavalry. Getting restless. And poor old no, really? Hanky Panky McSpanky is down already. Shot with a headshot. Poor McSpanky. And now you can see these guys from the 11th Texans and the 7th Texans getting into that building so that they can provide some defenses, breaking the glass. Only two windows, no, three windows, correction, overlooking the churchyard and the other buildings here. The bell tolling. Beware for whom the bell tolls. And somebody playing with their organ. This is just ridiculous. Hurrah. Look at this, nice dancing being done by Recruit Gutty, who's playing the organ. It's Private Dandy playing with his organ again. Hurrah. So let's see. Corporal Samus from the 68th. And the bell continuing its mournful tone. Captain Krasak, no doubt, for whom the bell tolls. Now, let's see what's going on over here by this fine house. As you can see, Jefferson Sherman of the 3rd US. And here is Thomas Beale, looking as smart as ever. Don't tell me somebody else is playing. Oh, listen to that. Oh, really? You stop as soon as I arrive. Never mind. Anyway, these boys from the 7th Texan, Private Jancia, now moving out of the building, if somewhat getting stuck in near the windows. The theme from Gods and Generals. And now let's see. Here is Camaradera from the 41st. The infantry, look at these guys. Rigoberto and Colonel Fernando from the 41st Tennessee. As it looks like we've lost Lefebvre, Charles, and Whitman as well. And here the 11th Texan continuing their defense as it looks like the Michigan Cavalry is getting out there. Look at that, fantastic. Let's see if we can find those guys. They must be around somewhere. Oh, look at that, Kino. Oh my goodness. It's Fort Derp. It's the artillery Fort Derp with the defensive position. as Musico Corella is being, or Gorella is being built up on top of those things. So, here is our pad.
Long live the Union.
So, oh dear, Krasik has fallen out of the church. There's Retima with a little bit of drive-by. Retima and Lokel having a punch up. Good to see that. Any issues relating to what's the word I'm looking for? Ah, screw it, I can't remember. Cannot for the life of me remember. Discipline, that was it. And there's Retima. Dear, oh dear. Anyway, fine fifing. Who's fifing? It's that boy there. Anyway, it looks like Charles Wicks has just murdered the colonel of the 1st Tennessee. And we're looking at the 68th here. The bell still continues its tolling. Oh, goodness me. Here's Brigadier General Numitor looking for quarry. Looking for a target. Out comes the Colt. Takes a pot shot and then cheeses it in the opposite direction. As here is the United States sharpshooters in the church. Always a force to be reckoned with. Oh, look at this. Dr. Henkel. Free amputation since 1822. Oh, God. Would you trust this man with a sword or a saw? No, I don't think I would either. To be honest, it's probably just going to be like a vet. It'll just come over and shoot you in the head. It'll save time. The fine traditions of the Hinkle family and Dr. Hinkle. So, you can see the firing continuing. As these guys seem to have a slightly large building with holes in it. So. No, down goes Ippen. Ippen killed by the cannonball. Poor Ippen. No more charging for Ippen. As you can see, Shanika continuing to push close. Oh dear. That's painful. No, down goes Shanika. Killed by Zvaron. It's these guys over here. 68th New York. Continue to fight back. Heinrich Hein. Oh, waiting around the corner, it's Lord Jesus! The Lord of all things cheese is defending. Look at that. And a fine stab into Charles Wicks. As Lord of Cheeses continues to survive. Oh, beautiful music. That's one of my favourite pieces of music in this game. It really is. Just a beautiful piano piece of the battle cry of freedom. Down goes Jesus, sliced unceremoniously by Halukta. And another attempt by Halukta there, got the attack, but now is bleeding, is being hit. Can he survive? He's going to be bleeding. No, he cannot survive, but this could be a problem for Lakeisha, as Lakeisha is probably bleeding out now. Not sure why it keeps restarting, which is a shame. Anyway, down goes Volunteer Thomas, barged to the floor by a horsey from the 8th Florida. And here are the 8th Florida continuing to ramage around the area. And Retimar's just killed Kino Jr. Whoops-a-daisy. And it looks like a little bit of... And Retimar then gets murdered. So here is the Florida Cavalry. Moving out. There's Drury. He seems to be holding a card in his mouth. Obviously waiting to go out for a game of poker after the battle if he survives. Yep, there we go. The Ace of Spades. And who can forget the recent passing of Lemmy from Motorhead with that fine song. Anyway, bit out of the area to say the least, but yeah. A fine tune. Oh goodness. Ichabod Crane. And Sturrock defending himself. Down goes Sturrock, barged to the floor by the horse. Sliced and barged and... Oh god, he just got diddled by a load of horses. That's not good. Ichabod Crane also unceremoniously murdered nearby. Poor Ichabod. So, we're looking at 18 and 27. The Union still has the advantage. Even though the roaming of the Florida cavalry will give them some problems. There's Captain Melcio of the 11th Texan hiding behind the Parrotsville sign. And over the bridge goes the Florida cavalry. We shall follow them forward. As you can see them now, trying to make a charge into the building. We'll follow Private Davy. Their ex-Private Davy, unfortunately, murdered by Cooper Miller and friends in their defensive position. Until the all-charge command is given. As over here, you can see Melcio waiting for the boys to come out. They've been given the all-charge. It's possible they may be trying to go out the other entrance. We'll wait and see what happens. Melcio might get a sudden surprise. Down go. Look at that. Melcio going in for the attack. Murdered horribly by the United States sharpshooters. Gang banged by sharpshooters. Never a pleasant experience. As Barry Butterfield. 18 and 8. It's the Confederacy remaining. Oh, random horse dies. And look at this. We're getting General Numitor. And now, Locale of the Alabamans. Lion Draw, also of Alabama. Here's Grella the musician. And the attack on the bridge begins. Look at this, it's going to be nasty. Down goes one, down goes two. It's fair to say the Union might have the advantage. That's exactly what's happened as the 21st Alabama. I've just lost multiple people. As you can see, down goes the final one with Grella, the last man standing. So we shall move on to the next round, which will be the final one. And here we are in the final round of tonight's battle. I hear music. Fine drumming work and fifing occurring in the world of North and South. And they stop when I get there. God damn it. Oh my goodness. It's a lot of the 47th Virginia all in as musicians. Look at that. Fantastic. Now the question is, will they do play together? They can. Fantastic. Colonel Anderson leading the boys forward. A little bit. Yeah, someone isn't playing together. See, there you go. How hard is it to click a check? There we go. They nearly got it together. There we go. Perfect. And there's always one. How hard could it be to click play together? God damn it. Anyway. Who's this over here? It's Private Hudson from Maine. As down goes the muffin, the McMuffin is down. And the cannon with Major Boucher from Maine. The Murfster. And the engineer quick one. He's going to have to be damn quick because the cannon's pointing right at him. Don't dig fast. Dig quickly. And that's exactly what he's done. He's just given them a nice little bit of protection there. As the quick one continues his engineering work. I love this game so much because of the engineers. The engineers, unsung heroes of the battles. Fantastic. As down goes Staff Kavanagh as well. Oh goodness, the Florida Cavalry has absolutely butchered the enemy. But it looks like this might be the Michigan Cavalry going after the Alabamans. As it is. Oh no, it's the Florida Cavalry. Look at that, the Lance of Florida coming in. The pointed attack of the Florida Cavalry. Brutal, brutal goings on there. And a cannonball as Lakeisha is taken down. As there's Kino Chan, who still remains alive. As the Florida Cavalry regroups. And here is this regrouping with their lances, getting ready to move out. As no, down goes PFC, Captain Schnitzner. And there, of course, is the church bell. Now the question is, who's in here ringing his bell? It's the 16th Alabama. You can see them defending. Playing with his organ, it's McKinney. As always, there's always somebody going to be playing with their organ in the church. Even though that's probably against the teachings of the church under the circumstances, but you know. What can you do? It's a time of war, it's a time of battle, it's a time of stress. Certain, let's just say the word, let me think about that right word. Certain allowances are made. Under. Oh, goodness me, that's not looking good for them. Open the door, press fire, and close the door. Love it, that's fantastic. Let's see who these guys who are opening the door are. There we go, there's Rick Galloway from the 3rd US. I love the fact that they're closing the door afterwards as well. That's just polite doormanship there. And working together with Rick Galloway as John Smith recruit. Oh goodness me, what happened there? Oh dear. Oh goodness, what's going on over here? Oh goodness, that looks wrong on many, many levels. Yeah, Galloway, you should be ashamed of yourself. There's not time for that sort of thing in the man's army. And, oh no, that's a very nasty landing. Oh God, that's an even more painful landing. Holy crap, that's a very brutal death. Very brutal deaths going on there. Now, Staff Lieutenant Cocaine. And find posters up for rallying around the flag. There's probably going to be a Chad poster around here somewhere. And a Diplex poster in here as well, of course. We'll find Mr. Diplex. So let's go and see what's going on. That's one of the townhouses. There is Cocktail Gunter. Not sure what's going on. There's a flag. We go downstairs. And here is Heinrich Hein. These guys defending themselves. And it looks like the United States sharpshooters Brutus has taken down Monkey Boy. And they're continuing to fire back at the enemy. Ouch! Gustav Black taking a nasty shot. He's going to be bleeding and in trouble. go downstairs. Who's on the piano? It's Alexander Daventry from the 3rd US. Overlooked, and I cannot for the life of me remember who that is. It almost looks like Lincoln, to be honest, without a beard. But a very haunting piano rendition. As Manly Pleasington shot down, and the music still continues. Look at that. And it's all over. So, oh goodness. It's the new line of submarine staff members. Veteran Cloud Runner. Underwater. And it's not going to go well for him. He's just about to start breathing the water. And then we'll float down the river. Like a Mars bar. Oh. There we go. Cloud Runner. No more clouds. No more running. Let's find the drum regiment, shall we? As here is Fiddy going up against Murfster. Murfster then killed. As the 2nd Massachusetts continuing the melee. As Pacifist has been killed. You kind of expect that, really, to be honest with that name. Aragorn Senpai. There's Colonel Brutus with his horn. More organ play. Hurrah, hurrah. And Lefebvre Charles is no more murdered. But, oh, goodness. What happened there? How did he die? Well, there we go. The bell's tolling for him as well. And Colonel Brutus continues to toll the bell. Oh, he's joining in with his horn as well, really? Someone fell. Nasty. Who's playing with their organ? Nobody. Wow. So it's Private Dandy. Won't even ask how that's done. So, let's see. And the organ is finished. As the 3rd US are now. Let's see. 16 and 19, the Confederacy have the advantage. As Melcio leads out horribly. And here we go, it's the all charge time, boys and girls. There's the flag from LS. There's Grella the musician, the last survivor of the previous round. Firing off their guns to make sure. Now, let's see. There's Kino Jr. Colonel Lakel of the 21st Alabama. And here are the United States sharpshooters. Making their way across the big bridge of Parrotsville. Colonel Brutus leading the boys forward. Getting him set up. Getting him ready for the fight on the bridge. Looks like they've decided to go in the opposite direction for some reason. Aha, that's why. Here is their quarry, their enemy. They're all... they're friends with bayonetty fun. And there goes Cocaine and Grella. And the stabby goodness begins in the view of the pub as well. So whoever wins gets to have a beer after. As down goes, let's see, Woods leader, recruit Woods leader of Alabama. VM King also taken down, Quartermaster Sergeant. As Kino also horribly murdered by Todd Essential. And you can see this guy trying to defend himself. He gets cornered. This is going to be bad for him. And he dies horribly. as the Confederacy has won that round. That is it, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for watching the Union Line battle for this evening. I hope you've enjoyed. And my thanks, obviously, to all the admins and to all the regiments for attending. Without them, this would be nothing. So for that, I will be forever thankful. Thank you very much, everyone. As I completely lose control of the English language, I will bid you farewell. Take care.